have another celebrity guest right here in the studio, like I promised. I have Lumine Norse here with me. How are you feeling today?
I'm all right. How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you. So, for people who don't know who you are, can you give us a brief journey into the music industry, like how you've gotten to where you are at the moment?
Okay. I'm not going to tell you I started from church. No, I did not. I've actually been around for quite a long while. It's just been like from Festac Town, Nigeria, you know. I started with a group then and all that. It's been a whole lot of years. I've been in a couple of stages, and I'm actually a very, very versatile artist. I grew up with the likes of Two Face, grew up with the likes of Sultan, Cartier, and you know, people like that. So I'll just say Luminous is just someone who is music, who loves music. I don't stop doing music, and I drop all different kind of styles, rap, singing. So basically, that's just really all about me, yeah.
Okay, so your full name is Olumide Falakwe, right?
Yeah, Olumide Falakwe.
You're also the grand nephew of Victor Olaya.
Yeah.
Tell me, what is your favorite song from,
I'm not saying this because it's the I'm not trying to like make you guys, you know, but his favorite songs that I like are the ones he actually didn't release.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, there's a special one he used to sing to my mom, because like my mom was his favorite, you know.
Oh, wow.
So, you know, yeah, so it's something like that, you know. So that's my favorite song, like that he ever sang, you know.
My mom used to listen to it. I was saying to you just before we came on air, my mom used to listen to a lot of it, especially in the mornings. And I can just remember one that goes like, I don't know what language is that, where he goes, Victor Laya, Nicabulayo.
That's actually Ekiti. That's a deeper version of Yoruba, yeah. I'm from Ekiti State, yeah.
Probably. So what does that mean?
Sing it again, come here.
I think it goes, Victor Laya, Nicabulayo.
Okay. It's like you know, from Ekiti we have this kind of we call it Iwi or something it has to do with your lineage, and they kind of Niger people, we're all Niger now, we have got aliens, you know, the way they hail you, you know. It's like it comes with who you are, your lineage, your kind of people, what they say about you, like Ekun or Kurimeta, you know, like, you know, you know what I mean? So that's like his, you know, that's how they hail him, you know.
Okay.
It's like, yeah. So,
okay. So you made a sing-along jingle for Governor Akinwumi Ambode.
Yes.
And with Ashiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, Claire wrote for Ambode.
Yeah.
How did that come about?
I'll say it was just God, because I was actually doing a jingle for one other senator and someone who was aspiring to be Federal House of Rep. So it was so good, but he didn't win the primaries.
Okay.
You know, so he thought that, wow, this song is so good, and he's like very close to Tinubu and all that. So he was like, man, why don't you get a song, do a song for Ambode?
Okay.
You know, so I thought about it, I said, oh, wow, I've never really had the chance to sing, like, you know, on that kind of level, on that kind of skill, you know. And luckily for me, it was endorsed by Tinubu, and it was really, 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 really a club banger, and it was really, really nice. Performed at a lot of stages, at Ikorodu, at Sulere, with the likes of Davido, the likes of them, yeah. So it was quite an experience. Anyway, I just walked into a club one day, and luckily I just ran into him, and he told me, like, go do this. So it was just God that directed my steps. And so, you know, but it was a good song. The voice is a political song, so we can't really, you know,
kind of dwell on it or go back to it.
It was
a song for the season.
For the season, yeah.
Okay, brilliant. So from lullabies to playing your guitar to rap, that's like a whole range. You're multi-talented, I have to say.
Nigeria, we vex for Nigeria. You know, Nigeria is one industry that, man, the artists, the hardworking, yeah, thumbs up to them, you know, they don't rest. So we too, we don't sleep, man.
So what would you say is the major message that your music portrays to the rest of the world?
Okay, basically, most of my songs is majorly about moral advice.
Okay.
Because I'm a kind of youth that grew up somewhere that I didn't actually have all the things, all the positive minded people and things that were put in place for me to be someone. You understand? We didn't really have too many good role models. So I felt, why don't we just talk and try to, you know, bring out the best out of this youth. But Nigerian industry is kind of, you know, somehow you gotta kind of sing some jingles, party stuff, go off points a little bit, you know, the fans are crazy. So that's why I mix a little bit of play here and there. But my real message is moral advice.
Okay. I have to ask you this. This is a little bit random. What embarrassing songs would I find on your playlist right now?
Oh my god. Sometimes, man, I wonder. I'd be like, man, can I just take this off Google? Because, you know, like, it's been like many years, and there were like songs I did like many years ago, although a lot of my songs are still way better than a lot of songs, like my old songs are still way better than a lot of songs that the new artists are coming with. I'm not mentioning names. Yeah. So the thing about it is, I can't really say there's anything really embarrassing. Like, it can't be that bad.
Mention one song that you think that
people
will be
song.
Like, ah, how could that be on your playlist?
okay someone else's song.
Yeah, of course.
I just got it now.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Man, I listen to Sam Smith, though.
Oh!
Man, I don't listen to it with... I don't like driving the car with guys and listen to Sam Smith. Oh, no, I don't do that. Man. I just listen to it codedly with my earpiece. I'm like, listen to it. I don't
know why. Okay. Brilliant. What's this year looking like for you? What do you have planned for 2016?
Afro Rhythms, Luminous 2016. Takeover, man. No time. That's exactly what we're about, all about now.
I like the fact that you speak your Bible now and again. It shows your authenticity and originality.
Yeah.
Can I ask you something? What are your pre-show rituals? What do you do just like that second before you get on stage?
Before I get on stage? Okay. You know, there's this thing about this getting on stage. You always have this little... No matter how, you can't shake it without tiny nervousness. So I kind of talk to myself, Luminous Asati. I just talk to myself like I'm a second person, like my Luminous and the Sun Man, a bad man. You know, just heal myself. But when I get up, I'm like, I did that just right out there, like, man, the Sun Man, bad man, you know, that kind of thing. So
that's
just my secret, man.
Brilliant. Okay, so I have to ask you another random question. You're not going to believe this question I'm going to ask you.
Oh,
who owes you money?
There are plenty.
Mention
you know yourself. I won't mention your name, girl. Anyway, nobody really owes me money. I say,
you've probably done a lot of shows.
A whole lot of them. A whole lot of unappreciative people, but we thank God, because if not for all the good and the bad and the ugly, I wouldn't be here today. I wouldn't be signed up to Afro Rhythms. I wouldn't be here expressing myself. I won't be on most of the top stages I've been to. Some of them, a lot of them I did it for free, but, you know,
yeah.
I'll join, man. I keep it.
We all have to pay our dues.
Yeah, and our dues, man. I swear.
So you have a new music video. Tell us a little bit about that music video.
Okay, the song is like Whoa.
Okay.
And the thing about the song is, it's like a mix of, you know, kind of, it's like a grime song. It's like international. You know, you could say it's because, why I'm saying this is it doesn't really have a particular genre. That song can't really be classified like Afrobeat or grime alone or something, because it has this Jamaican kind of thing in it. It has Afro. Thing, you know, Nigeria, I must put my Yoruba thing in it. So there's this low key part of it. You know the way you move your body like, well, the way you're moving, you know, like, you're smooth for the girls. You get what I mean? I brought it back to the, you know, like, well, you know, so it's basically, you know, everything, dance, party, happy song.
What would you say was the most challenging time for you during the video shoot?
Oh, the video shoot was when the rain started and the drone was high up in the air.
Okay.
And the rain was really kind of heavy. I was scared it was going to blow up. It was, you know, cost a whole lot of money. So I was scared it was going to blow up or something, you know, it may be worse if it blew up for my head, you know, spoil my fine boy and all that. But it was throughout the video, you know, I'm the kind of person that I'm always in a happy mood, and I can't really say this was the, that was the, but the rain was kind of challenging, but it made it all better, you know.
Okay. I have one more random question for you before we go into your music video. What do you think was the hardest thing for you to give up on at any time of your life? What was the hardest thing you had to give up on?
Well, the hardest thing I had to give up on was a lot of my friends. Why did I say that was my kind of mission? My mission is not just to drop one song today and come back next month or next year, sorry. I like to drop songs back to back. I'm a recording artist, producer, and I like to drop songs back to back. And the kind of friends I had, there were some kind of people that actually slowed me down. And I just had to choose, you know, cut the bullshit. So I just had to just really choose and, you know, throw away my SIM card. Don't do me wrong. I threw my SIM card, man. Like, but what am I going to do? You know, that's really, you know, sometimes I look back and I feel like, ah, oh, this guy. Because I like funny people and stuff, but
you're funny. No
time.
You're definitely
funny.
Okay, so I'm going to let you look into your camera and introduce your music video.
Shake, like, whoa. I like the way you move your body down, like, whoa. I get the money and I put it down, like, whoa. I want you to make you move your body down, like, whoa. Like, whoa, like, whoa, like, whoa. Duh, shake, like, whoa. My name is Luminous, aka Luminati, Badman of Badman Team, AfroRhythms.com, UK. Today we're live up in Ben TV. Like, whoa. That's all. Alisa.
Okay. Brilliant.